All right, y'all, what's going on? It's Combo Breaker 99. I am back with another post-fight analysis video. All right, the co-main event. Co-main event, Joanne Wood versus Alexa Grasso. All right, so yeah, man, look, I knew this fight was going to probably go this way as far as, you know, Grasso getting the nod or, you know, getting the victory. However, you know, I definitely knew that was a possibility. But I said, okay, you know, I'm going to ride with JoJo all the way. You know, I was going to do a fan pick and an analysis pick. You know, definitely was my fan pick was going to be for Wood. You know, like I said, just riding with her for a long time. So I had to say, okay, my fan pick is her. But, you know, of course, my analyst pick, I said, okay, I'm going to go across the board, just say JoJo. But deep down, I said, analyst pick, you know, Grasso's going to win this fight. Come on. You know, I've been watching these fighters fight longer than most of y'all that are simping over Grasso just for a couple of months now, right? So, you know, I know this game, you know, so I just want to address that out there. People say, oh, I told you so. You ain't tell me nothing. You know, I know this game. Anyways, Alexa Grasso, she went in there and got it done. And like I said, this submission win that she got was definitely in the cards, because if anybody goes to the ground, I knew it was going to favor Alexa Grasso, because Alexa Grasso has been working more on her ground game. And, you know, she has been filling out a little bit more. And this is Joanne Calderwood. This is Joanne Wood. You know, Joanne Wood is definitely not the best fighter on the ground. So at the same time, I really wasn't like wowed, but I was kind of wowed because this was the first finish for Alexa Grasso. First finish of her career, you know, So I got to give her credit, you know, got to give her a lot of credit here. But again, like I said, this is Joanne Wood. You know, Joanne Wood is on the downside, never really showed an evolution in the ground game. Just a little bit, but not a great deal to make me say, oh, wow, you know. So, yeah, I expected this. You know, I expected this. But on the feet is where I can kind of say, oh, I told you so, because Joanne Wood was having some good moments against Alexa Grasso on the feet, in my opinion. You know, she was landing her front push kick to the face, you know, and to the body. You know, she was getting off some good shots. That's why Alexa Grasso showed, okay, you know, I got to take this thing to the ground. And that's what I'm saying about well-roundedness. Well-roundedness and doesn't necessarily mean, okay, I can do whatever I want in the fight whenever. It's about having to go to a plan B when you're forced to, because you see in this fight, JoJo was coming on strong with some of her strikes. You know, some of her kicks were kind of giving Alexa Grasso problems. So Alexa said, okay, we're going to take this thing to the ground because my ground game is better, right? So she went to the plan B here, and that's why how she showed you that well-roundedness here. So yeah, man, shout out to Alexa Grasso. She got it done. Like I said, I expected it because, yeah, she was the fresher of the two. You know, if you go back and look at the first round, like I said, right away, JoJo, she wanted to apply pressure just to stop the footwork of Grasso. And it was working a little bit. But, you know, you could see Grasso's hand speed. She landed a few good right hands, you know, punching in the clinch, taking the fight to the ground the first time around. Grasso was in the guard, you know, using that head for control. But they go back to the feet. You know, she's able to separate back to the feet. But here's where you see JoJo getting in some shots, you know, landing a few 1-2s, backing her to the cage, some knees and jabs here that were effective. I thought the range was actually affecting I thought it was favoring JoJo more here. You know, like I said, landing those good push kicks. You know, she did that push kick to the body of Grasso. Then she stepped in with that spinning back fist. Now, spinning back fist was about to look impressive. You know, it did partially land. But Grasso, you know, she did a nice little maneuver as it kind of connected to the side of the head. She locked on to the body, locked on to JoJo, took her down, took this fight back down to the ground, got the back of JoJo. And just in a matter of seconds, she was able to latch on, snake that arm up under the neck, much like Taylor Santos did, lock it in for the RNC, and JoJo was tapping. And I was like, oh boy, here we go again. So yeah, man, Alexa Grasso gets her first finish in the UFC. I was impressed with her just to kind of, you know, switch up that gear when her striking wasn't working. She said, okay, I'm gonna take this thing to the ground. Now, not saying that her striking probably wouldn't have started working later on down the stretch of the fight, but right away she said, I'm not gonna bang with JoJo, I'm gonna go ahead and take her to the ground. If I get the finish, there it is. And there it was. You know, so yeah, man, shout out to Grasso. As for Joanne Wood, I really think it might be time. Unfortunately, I mean, she's given us the best that she could as far as performances, even for me. You know, me saying that as a fan of JoJo, I've already seen the best out of her, so I can just go back and watch old fights now. But I really don't want to see a fighter like her get hurt anymore. You know, this is what, 3 back-to-back losses? Because let's see, she She won against Jessica Eye. Then she lost to Lauren Murphy, Taylor Santos, and Grasso. And these last two fights, they were just, you know, harsh. You know, they were just harsh on her, you know. So if you're not really going to make improvements, you know, the improvements that you need, like in defense, moving your head, your ground game, you know, just all around, even takedown defense. And this division is just getting deeper. I mean, you just might have to call it a day, man. That's why I'm saying this. It's weed them out season, you know. Everybody that was supposed to win won, you know. Jennifer Maya, her and JoJo, you know, they're two of the ones on the downside as of recently. Also, you know, Roxanne Modafferi, she was on that list, but she retired. You know, these are the fighters that probably need to be, you know, making their way out the division soon, right? Just to kind of make way for the new flyweights. So, yeah, man, moving forward for Alexa Grasso, she's starting to look the part of, like I said, like a strong flyweight, you know, showing that ground game and the well-roundedness here. I think moving forward, just to show she's title shot ready, which we'll talk about in another video, is, you know, her really growing into it, really growing into that flyweight strength against some bigger fighters. You know, that's why, honestly, maybe since Jennifer Maya was number four here, I would like to see that fight. Like, let's see what Jennifer Maya can do. Let's see what Alexa Grasso can do against Jennifer Maya. I think it's her turn to fight Jennifer Maya now, you know, just to kind of see if she can handle that big type of fighter and that type of boxing, you know, a big fighter that's going to throw back. Because, it was a finish over Joanne Wood, but as Joanne Wood, it doesn't really say that you're still ready for that elite. And I think she voiced that in her recent interview as well. Correct me if I'm wrong. She did say, I need more fights, or I need more experience before I fight Valentina Shevchenko. So she straight up said it. Like, even though she was number 9 or number 10 and she just beat number 7, she still said, hey, I ain't ready, you know. So she's kind of backtracking too. So we know she's not ready. Alexa Grasso already stated she's not ready for Valentina Shevchenko. So in the meantime, she's got to get that work in against, you know, the Lauren Murphys, the Jennifer Mayas. Hell, even still possibly fighting the winner of Viviana Arujo versus Andrea Lee. You know, so she doesn't seem like she's really pushing for a Valentina fight yet. And I can tell you right now, Alexa Grasso's not ready. So if you simping for Alexa Grasso and you think she's ready, hey, you better go back and rethink that, because even she's not feeling that. So, yeah, other than that, shout out to Grasso for getting the victory, because, yeah, we do need some new blood here. So we'll just kind of see where she goes. Just kind of watch her in the background. She works. But, you know, there's these other fighters like Santos and Manon that are ready. You know, so I'm watching them and seeing how they can prepare for Valentina. But that's another video I'm going to talk about Grasso. You know, some of her recent comments about facing Shevchenko. We'll talk about that. But, yeah, next thing for JoJo, I think it's just time to call it a day. You know, just being real. Don't want to see anybody get any more hurt than they already are. So, yeah, guys. That's all I got on this one. Give me y'all's thoughts. Combo Breaker 99. I'm out. Subscribe. Peace.